In 43 of the past 50 years, healthcare spending has outgrown GDP. The US spends about $3 trillion a year on healthcare, which amounts to about $10,000 per person. Healthcare has been relegated to a series of innovations that have been about preserving the status quo and helping existing participants advance their business. But where the Internet of Things becomes interesting is it has the potential to totally change the way US healthcare works. So as we think about how the Internet of Things might develop, there clearly is a large commercial opportunity. This could be something like a $30 billion industry, up from nothing today. When we think about the Internet of Things in healthcare, we're thinking about mobile devices that connect all the different participants, the patient, the caregiver, a provider, and allows for information to be delivered that informs a clinical decision. So when we look at the Internet of Things, we identified three key categories. The first is remote monitoring, and think about remote monitoring as a way to constantly connect a patient and a caregiver. So a patient goes and has a procedure or has a specific condition, and remote monitoring allows that patient to be evaluated all the time from anywhere around the world through a smartphone or a tablet or some type of implant. And one example I think that tells the story about remote monitoring is diabetes. So diabetics have the need to monitor their glucose levels all the time. And what remote monitoring does, it connects glucose readings to a smartphone, to a physician, and that closed ecosystem allows a doctor to modulate someone's care. The second area is telemedicine. And telemedicine is among sort of the quote lowest hanging fruits here. And the reason for that is it's essentially just adding on another activity to one of the many, many things that people now do on their smartphones versus what might have been done in person even 5 to 10 years ago. And as you think about adding applications to a smartphone, where telemedicine becomes so interesting for the Internet of Things is you can reduce a lot of headache in terms of basic medical care. If you have a child who has an ear infection, you can do all that remotely. So think about all the time you save. You're not going to a doctor, you're not making an appointment, you're not traveling. You probably don't even have to go to a pharmacy to fill a prescription anymore when you link that all together. The third area is behavior modification. And essentially what behavior modification involves is identifying certain health characteristics and communicating with patients about what they should do to address those health characteristics. So great example would be high cholesterol. So what behavioral modification technologies offer is almost like an instruction manual. And the ones that we think have the potential to be most successful are sort of like a life coach in your pocket. Like any new technology, the Internet of Things for healthcare is going to face a series of challenges. The US healthcare system has so many participants, payers, doctors, hospitals, patients, all of those individuals need to be on the same page to make this technology work. Taking a step back, this technology has the potential to take a system that's been really slow to change and turn it on its head, where by the next 50 years, look completely different than the prior 50.